Real Talk Jamaica. I'm your girl, Quanna Harris. We're proudly sponsored by Instinct Media Production. We have an exciting show lined up for you today. So get ready for my story.
Only I
can tell my story.
Delving into the life of a unique figure in the reggae and dancehall scene, Snagga Puss, originally known as Norman Supriya, started his career as Dickie Rankin. Snagga found his true voice by blending Jamaican culture with an animated twist inspired by a classic cartoon character. Let's get into his story. Hello, Mr. Snagga Puss.
Bless up the audience and the whole family and the whole circulation of this interview right now.
All right. So, Snagga Puss, you're originally from Arnett Garden, a place where deep rooted in Jamaican culture. How did your upbringing shape your music?
Well, it shaped my music nice because at the time, when I'm dealing with the music and this whole inspiration of dancehall, First, we used to go to this dance regular and you have Trevor Rankin, Nicodemus, all them DJ there, Uri and the sound system, and I say I want to be a DJ.
Right.
And me have to go pick a name. Mm-hmm. So I seen Trevor Rankin and Rankin Joe, I say, well, it's a Dickie Rankin. So I give the name Dickie Rankin now and start, you know, do my thing. I never write the lyrics yet. I always come from the memory box of the mind.
Okay.
So I'm good at originate lyrics on spot.
Okay.
I can create a lot of lyrics on spot. So that was a good talent for me. So from there on, Dickie Rankin going on, all kind of style, all kind of fashion, and it grew me, come right up to where I am now.
Okay, so you are in New York now as Dickie Rankin.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us the scene of Dickie Rankin them time there in a New York City.
Well, Dickie Rankin in New York City now, well, for the first time when we go into America.
Right.
It's not 45 carousels. Them time they have a DJ, good, and then man, I listen cassette. That CD,
yes.
Cassette.
Mm-hmm.
So a cassette, and I say, boy, me hear Dickie Rankin pana Gemini. Panajaro, and them want me to come a foreign. So, first time we go a foreign, me and Buru Bantan.
Okay.
And me and Buru Bantan go now, and we go to Chicago. Then we come back to New York. Then in New York now, we start, you know, every time you travel, you study more and more and more. Because you have to keep studying. Because it's a thing where you learn every day. In music and in life, you learn every day. So, I was a person like that, open up for learn.
Right.
So, you know, in Dickie Rankin, you know, that's where I learned how to rap, to do rap music.
So you don't rap to Snagga
Puss? Yeah, me don't rap to man. Yeah, Dickie Rankin, do a music called Rap Man.
Okay.
Diling, diling, ding, 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 diling, diling, ding, 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 I'm the Rap Man. Yeah. And Rap Man, no, 5'9", yo, dark complexion. I rap with a microphone in my right hand. Rough and tough like Michael Jordan. On the rebounds like Elijah Wan, yeah. Slam dunk like Kobe Bryant. Take control like Tim Duncan. So, rapping was easy for me.
What did that mean? Because it was
flow.
Flow.
Yeah, easy. It's easy because, you know, rapping is the rap culture come from Jamaica, you know. And when you lay a hip-hop beat, you have to first lay the drums. And when the drums them, you lay in a dancehall beat, and you lay in, say, you lay in the puna on the rhythm, you lick the drum first. Boom, 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 snare and drum. And then boom, 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 the bass go after.
Right.
So automatically, the hip hop was first.
Okay.
Lay in, then the bass go line, so it's straight dancehall. So that's how I learned to rap.
Okay.
And that's how I know that hip-hop originate from dancehall.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of people wouldn't know because as me hear me say, boom, 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 boom.
It's
bang, bang, guitar go on. So when bass and guitar go on, it changed from hip hop to the dancehall. So that's how, you know, and I jump around and I used to do all my rapping style. Don't test me, cause I'm close to top. I'm trying.
Oh, yes, sir.
So always a style and sound. Because I know to create style and stuff.
Right.
So that's when I'm in New York now, so I learn a lot of things. You know, and start to, you know, the Yankee them now, they love the Jamaican music.
Mm-hmm.
So when I can rap, most times most DJ come from Jamaica and them go to the Yankee club, I get a show, they don't rap the crowd as much because true, them a DJ for them patois style and it never so catch on. But me, they don't know me catch on to the rapping.
Mm-hmm.
So me can DJ for them, understand me now. So that's all the whole thing with Dickie Rankin in New York, you know, and get famous and grow and grow and grow and grow. You understand me? So here I am grow, then after Dickie Rankin, you know, you have the style start change.
Right.
Where a lot of DJ come now, the Bunty, the Capertan, the Beanie Man, and all them coming now. So me have to go find a style now for match back with, you know, Dickie Rankin, I kind of fade out.
Okay, so that's what brought on the transition now when you came back to Jamaica. You rebrand yourself now as Snagga Puss.
Snagga Puss, because I have to go back, go study now, do some homework, to come back with a pattern and a style for rank with these DJ now, because the cycle changed.
Right.
I'm going to say, all right, well, you have a Capertan, you have a Ninja Man, you have all of them come now, and so I love cartoon.
Right.
So I say, lad, I've got find a style for match back with them artists, you know. So I watch a cartoon named Yogi Treasure Hunt.
Yes.
With a little puss named Snaggle Puss. I'm say, I'm here the first time I hear that puss, when it's like I'm going to a cave, I meet up on a lion. I'm going to him say, oh, Cousin George. This is cause of Snag. So, and the lion goes, whoa. And him run out now, him say, yike, I gotta get out of here. Left, exit, stage right, I'm out of here. And so when I hear that, I say, Lord, that style is unique. Well, if it make me laugh, so me can't carry it to the dance hall and make people laugh. So I start to practice that style.
Okay.
I practice it like they don't know. First time I ever learned, forget, forgot. Damn. With the part, damn. Damn, it kind of course. So I know, so I have to start exercise, gain more energy, and learn how to breathe proper.
Right.
Deep breathing, forget that energy out. So, you know, I practice to me the front, me from, damn, 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 yike, nice. So the way till I get it. So I get it now, then I say, yes, the first song that I put that style on, it was Anthony Red Rose producing a song with Anthony Malvo.
Mm-hmm.
And the song was so nice, but them say, them want something for go to it. So I said, I'm going to try that style to it. And I just go through the song and I say, yike, this is not a Benz, nor a Volvo, it's Anthony Malvo. And that song, take off. I say, take off now, till everybody I say, why that little voice that sound good? Snagga Puss. Snagga Puss. So nobody do ever knows me. Because I tell them, don't tell nobody yet. So I keep on, they know them got shocking vibes. I'm saying to Patrick Roberts, you know, some other style we can rock the world. I'm saying, let me hear it. I'm going to say, see this turn? Yike, nice. Dead with laugh. Everybody in the studio dead with laugh. So I say, okay. First song we do in that style now, that style, a song called Some Girl Can't Cook Man No Yam From Them. Them the girl have a big problem. Have some girl sweet and nice. They with them hungry with a dig out your tribe. See how you cook the ball, Jesus Christ. Girl boil the chicken and fry the rice. Yike. And that song take off. Then, next song now, Merle. A song named Merle when it's the boys, I'm just like them say, I'm Merle. Sorry, Earl. Can't know the boys, them different from the girl. Hi, Earl. Sorry, Earl. You can't know the boys, them different from the girl. Beside Paul, me think of Pauline. I'll be kick cause him ear, well, cream. face bleach out, we have to scream. So, you know,
you need for bust the one there, you need to care about the one there, right? Now. One, you need to care about Merle, right? Merle. Now.
Yeah, the read, yeah.
Because the weird, they're not dressed.
No, no, the I have that right already to him.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a snake grip, girl. Be careful how you're looking, girls. Yeah, like, I know every girl when you see a real girl. Damn, boys start dressed like girl. Yeah, like, and we living in a mix up world. Damn, so everything's set. And from there now, it reached further, and then Snagga Puss start, you know, get popular, bust me all over Japan.
Right.
I go all over the world now, Japan, Canada, America. Everywhere you go, it's just everybody will say the style for me, no? Yeah, like, place mash up. Then I start getting a little stylish, like, no? Then I say, all right, I'm going to find back a little upgrade. Then, see an ex-cartoon, Woody Woodpecker.
Pecker, yes, pardon
me. And then, then we catch that sound, you know, and say, get a ball for the Woody Woodpecker. Hoo-hey-ho, hoo-hey-ho, the Woody Woodpecker. Hoo-hey-ho, hoo-hey-ho. And that song,
Bust off again.
Then come forward again, now, Freddie McGregor.
Yes, I was going to ask you about that collaboration.
A collaboration, me and Freddie McGregor, mm-hmm. now, with Gussie Clark and Leng, say, them have a song. No more. I listen to it with Freddie McGregor. I must just put something to it. So I listened to the song, and it was, carry your brinko, my dear. Bring misery. Mm-hmm. Going from house to house, cause a disturbance. Mm-hmm. So I say, hey, blab them out, chatty chatty. You carry news from here and there and over there. You cause a disturbance. What a shame. You blab them out. And that's how that song, that was my biggest song. Cause it go almost to the British chart.
Okay.
Yeah, it go right to the British chart. And that was my biggest song today.
The most successful song today.
Right. And you know, from there, Snagga Puss, then Herbal Man gonna step in now.
Okay, thank you very much for that. Very eye-opening. But let us start now about the transition from the musician
to the herbalist. Man.
Mm-hmm.
Well, transition from the music to the herbal. Well, the music made me strong. I mean, do a lot of things, but when me need for, as how I want to live now, happy, live long, I see a lot of artists dying from strokes, high blood pressure, a lot of artists who are original in the music, I'm just dying. People just dying all around.
Right.
And I did have diabetes.
Okay.
That's how I get to really, because I say this diabetes cost me a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
I go doctor, I never like pill. Never like injection. Doctor give me a pill, and he hooked me up with I think a B12 in my vein, and I take it and I never get nowhere with that because I'm not feeling good. I'm not feeling the energy I want. Sometimes when up on the stage, come like, oh, I'm faint. You want to pass out, and you know.
Right.
So I say, well, I have to take care of my health and myself, and the best way for deal with the health is to start know your spirit. Which is your inner being, your inner man, the inner woman. Because this is what I make every man and woman understand. You are both male and female. 23 pair of chromosomes from your mother, and 23 pair of chromosomes from the father. So you are both masculine and feminine. Okay?
Okay?
You are both masculine and feminine. So you have the feminine energy and your masculine energy. How you know that now? You ever hear a boy? We call it a boy born, boy be born, and he grow him start go like a girl. He go on, you know? And yeah, so you find out what happened now. The masculine energy is up more than the feminine energy. So the feminine energy start to rise up now, and it start to be perform the soft talking. My dear, yes. Are you going, sir? So the feminine energy up. So you have to learn to balance back that energy now. And if you use the mother of that child, you train him all back to perform as a man. Because it can balance. But if you don't do nothing about it and you just love him, automatically him continue with the feminine energy high and the masculine energy low. So that's why a girl who play football now, when they play the football and them don't balance themselves, them have the masculine energy up and the feminine energy down. So them go on more like a man. Wear pants. One do this, one do that. Like I say, she a girl and she a go on like she a boy. So, but the scientific part of it is our masculine energy is up and the feminine energy is down. So that's why I tell every man and woman, say, you are both male and female, because mother and father is what make you, the divine energy used to bring you in the universe.
Okay.
So the transition now to the herbal now, well, I feel now this diabetes thing, you know, I take over, it's a kill enough people, cancer, all kind of sickness. And as me tell you, I pay advance about the money to take care of myself, and it never work. And I know that when I get the bottom line to the whole thing about the herbal now, it's God. The inner being, the inner power, because that's what heal you. Man money can't heal them. Because enough man rich.
Truth.
Enough man rich and the money can't buy the biggest and the dearest and medicine. God, you got some doctor, you know. And I'm going to tell you, say, you have got to pay $1.5 for this, and you're going to need an operation on the pancreas. And the test costs how much money. Some people don't have no money. But you have the money, you can't pay it, and you still don't get better.
So
because
true.
It's not the money, it's your levity that's count. Because if you live good and eat good and think good, you're all right. Because you know, you still have a good relationship with you and your spirit, which is God. You want to do something wrong, I expect to get right. No. And people today, what reaching them is them karma. Because...
Say that again, sir.
Them karma. Because you sow a bad seed, where you want it come? So you come back. What you sow is what you reap. What you give is what you get. So that's what the universe is going through now. And people are saying, Lord, that man them shouldn't dead. Because he was a peaceful man. You don't know nothing about. It's dark. But them say closet.
In them closet.
So you don't know where him do. That will happen to him. So this is what mixing up the world now. And see up that the police force in Jamaica, big up the JCF. Them get a lot of blame by people who think say the police can't save them life. Mm-mm. The police can't save your life if you're dead. Because the day when the karma ready for you and your time is up, expire, you have to go. So when the police did this, and the police moved down from a post, and them say, I don't know the policeman move him dead. No, I don't know the police move him dead. Him time come, because him sow a bad seed and it come, now the karma come. So, blessed is the child that have his own. That means, once you have your own mind, don't make people think for you. You're a leader, you're a God, and a God is what people look up to and people worship. And if you want people to look up to you and worship to you, live like a God. Don't be like a devil and don't live like a follower. Because a lot of people today, 95% of them are followers. They're afraid of the truth. And this is the truth. When you hear me say, police can't save you. Is you have to save yourself. And how you save yourself? By doing good, eating good, living good, and love and respect your brothers and sisters. Because all of us are one, you know. But if you don't see that oneness, you're going to live in the disconnected. And disconnected, you're going to fight against each other. So, herbal now, again, as I said, this is how the herbal bring out a lot out of me.
Okay.
This is how the herbal bring a lot out of me. I have to start care for myself.
Okay.
And care for other people. Mm-hmm. And every day I see people dying from diabetes, high blood pressure, poor circulation, all kind of sickness. So when me start get better now, feel good, this is how I know, all right, this is something that's serious. When I have the diabetes and I lose my nature, losing my eyesight, my feet start swell. People are say, Lord, they move me. I say, no, they move me. Bad eating. I was eating bad, living bad. So I say, well, since the doctor can't help me with the medicine I have to take, I have to go back to myself, the inner being, which is God. So I go back and I say, well, I meditation. I say, God, why? I make a confession. I never kill nobody yet. I never do people wickedness. The only thing me do, which is kind of evil and wrong, is interfere with the next man, woman. But
so,
no.
All right, what's up?
I interfere with the next man, woman, and that was wrong. So I said, no, me have sense. I mean, I do that no more, God. Give me a chance, God. At the age of 28, diabetes, I have no nature. I sleep at night time.
At 28, yes. Young man.
And I say, I have no nature. I sleep at night. For 1 month straight, I don't sleep at night. I'm just getting up peeing, urinating, and the hour. I get mager down and slim down. The people say, Lord, I'm a bitch. So,
that's Jamaican, that's it.
Yeah, but just start getting mager down. Lose weight and slim down and, you know, and depend on the verge, you turn a madman. Because once you're not asleep, the mind starts hallucinating.
Right.
Because you not get rest, the nerves not get rest. So, from there, I meet, talk to God, I get that forgiveness. And here I am now, 64-year-old, have no eyesight problem, no nerves problem, strong energy, well creative, same way, play football, play basketball, do track and field.
Look at that, and when you were 28, you couldn't do that?
No, I used to do it little, but now, in 64-year-old, if you go on a field and can slam down, you can shift, you can run 100 meters, because I am the one who take care of most of the entertainer part when it comes to sports. And tell you about an entertainer football match, I am the one who started and always get the team go play for the high school them or a club,
right,
and sponsor the club. Mm-hmm. So the track and field now, even me, Lexus, and a couple more guys run at Gibson Relay, where we have the entertainer relay team. And we come second to last. But it come like a wee win the race because two were the entertainer.
Right.
The cameraman now watch nobody else. He might watch Lexus, Snagga Puss. Watch, you know. So it's beautiful for, you know, the herbal field, you know, that's how me get to bring out the natural and me and the energy and health and can take care of others and try to educate the artists. A lot of artists make money and at the end of the day, come like them don't make nothing. Them can't look out for themselves. They don't do no business. Them unhealthy, smoke, and I'm a drink, and accept a thing that say, yeah, me have to smoke, me have to drink. No. When the body lack a thing named dopamine, hear it named dopamine, and where them say is dope, smoking, cocaine, yeah, smoke weed, them say a dope, which is drugs.
Right.
Well, when the body lack of dopamine, is when the body not getting enough rest, you not getting enough sunshine. Most people today sleep a day more than night.
Mm-hmm.
It's a Dracula life, back way. So the sunshine is so important. Your vitamin D,
right? Mm-hmm.
Your melatonin, your serotonin, and your dopamine. So when you get the sunshine in the day now, and you go to bed early at night, it's trans. When you rest now, you go to bed from 9, till 3 o'clock is good. 9 to 3 is a good sleep. 9 to 2, because you sleep before 12.
Right.
So when you get early rest now, the body can get to transform itself and release those chemicals that your body need, the dopamine, the serotonin, the melatonin. So that's the beauty of life now, when the artists them now get to sleep at night. Every night they might bleach, smoke, drink, sex, overrun the body, and the body tired out. And you sleep all day, you wake up back, you still not have energy. So you have to get something that give you a little energy.
Energy, right.
This is how the cocaine comes in.
Mm-hmm.
The smoking, the alcohol drinking, power, the body lack of dopamine. And dopamine is the happy hormone that gives you. So that's why the herbals man learned me nothing this herbal.
So you study about these herbs that you take and sell, or how you do about it?
Alright. First, I get to know the herbs and read books.
Right.
I read books and know herbs have 5 different names. Like them other herbs name, dark blood.
Mm-hmm.
Where them used for information and to get clean woman through.
Right.
And the other name for it is information bush. So it clean out information.
Mm-hmm.
You have the Guinean weed and all these herbs now. So I get to know them and know that one herbs have all 5 names. In America, they call it a different name.
Right.
In Germany, they call it a different name.
And it has a scientific name.
Name, so you know, that's why I get to learn a lot of things. That's why I come with the beat and say, come talk to the herbal man. Come visit the herbal man. Hey, clean the body, flush the body, purge the body, and remote the body. talk to the herbal man. Commission with the share interview the herbal man now. Right? So we are telling you how the herbal thing go now. So this is how the herbal go now. So I study in Germany for 5 years.
Really?
Yeah. And do biochemistry, quantum physics, cosmic matrix, and I learn about the whole chemistry of nutrition science.
Okay.
So this is how I get to learn so much things. That's why them say, you better than the herbal man. I say, no, I am not better than nobody. They have for them thing. They have for them. They're herbalists. I'm both a herbalist, a scientist, a nutritionist, and a psychiatrist. So this is how I unite everything in the field. And
right.
You can entertain. I can entertain it easy. I can rap with you easy, answer your question easy, because I do the quantum physics, the cosmic matrix, nutrition science in Germany.
So you're trained for this, man.
Yes, man. Then if you want to be a master, you have to full on
train. Wonderful.
Somebody in the past, before I reached this topic, and I learned to do the full 100.
Yeah.
Somebody coming to me and say, what is DNA? I'm in the past, yeah, man, DNA, man. The man said, what is DNA? What DNA mean? Me don't know. But me also say, DNA, you know, where? Man say, you don't know what DNA is, and you're talking about your doctor. And you're herbal, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, I was so ashamed. Then I go back, go study, and go find out, say, DNA really mean the person that you is, you know, your saliva. Somebody want to know, say, if you touch that person, or you rape the woman, you have to come with some saliva, or sperms, and it show your DNA, say, yes. Then I get to understand, so the DNA, divironuclear acid. RNA, ribonucleic acid. So I get to know everything, and I say, yes, God, I'm ready for them now. Ready
them
for
them.
Them
come at you, ready.
Them come at me, ready. Any sickness you come with, I can tell you about them.
Yes, but they're learning, though. They're taking everything, you know.
No, really, that's all yes, about life.
I'm taking in everything.
Mm-hmm. So that's how the herbal man there now, and Snagga Puss get back. Healthy and strong and healthy, and you know,
I'm fit like a figure.
So the whole thing now is that me tell the people them out there, love God and live. Cause you're taking care of God, you're taking care of yourself. Okay, you're taking care of God, taking yourself. You're taking care of your body, you have to take care of God. You know, take care of your body, God never take care of you. Cause I know you alone living at the body. You have a spirit inside of you, which is that inner voice, and it will call God. So it goes God and goddess, male and female. So respect to the man, respect to the woman. Show love to the man, show love to the woman. And I have one thing I want to make clear. I have a song that coming out named Mother God and Father God. Because everybody today know Father God, they don't know Mother God. And me always I say, my mother first is what I challenge with that. Everything when you see the bless my Father God. Yes, Father. Me say, oh, me never hear you say mother yet. So, woman, how? Me never hear you say Father. It's Father figure. And to when I was growing, I get to understand, say, the world messed up by this male chauvinist religion, where woman don't get no rights. To them, I say, woman can't preach. Woman nothing teach. And as Samson trimmed Delilah, Delilah trimmed Samson, and Adam and Eve make Adam sin, all kind of crap. That's all them set up all the world for crap about woman. And today, woman don't get respect. So I come to change that. I make you know, say, I am mother, make you there, and your father alone. And mama push you out, and mama feed you, and you get the breast, and then call it titty. Suck titty milk and she grow you and she strain you the weight and carry you around and you not show no respect. No one head no run house. The woman is a head, the man is a head, mother and father. And that was originate when a home run by mother and father. If you want to go somewhere, your father can't send you, you have to ask your mother. If mother say if you go, you can't go. Father can't say if you go. Because mother was the backbone of the civilization, family. The backbone of the family, so.
Okay, let us just piggyback on something or go back to your song, the song that you recorded with Freddie McGregor. How was it working with Mr. McGregor?
Well, working with Freddie McGregor, it was a good experience and excellent because he is a icon. Mm-hmm. And when you do a song with an international act and an icon, you make you feel great. So doing the song together with him was nice, and I get a good whoop of feedback because that song was playing, every disc jockey playing that song. And they play all over the world.
Right.
You understand me? So it was a wonderful experience and moment, and rise me up as an artist again to a rank, you know, where, yeah, two big man. And but him are the bigger man, but you know, we grew, and you know, and it was excellent, you know. So, and people accept me all over the world through that song, you know. So,
so that song basically opened doors for you,
open doors, a lot of doors, you know, and take me to international stature. So, you know, yeah, man, it was nice. I love it.
Great, great. But yes, you remember we spoke on the transition from being a reggae artist, a dancehall staple, to a herbalist. How was the transition being that persons, how persons accepted the transition, or did they not accept it?
Well, some people, majority accept it, some people never accept it. Some people say, you feel be a DJ, man, you know, you talk about your herbal, man, go back to DJ. And I say, I still DJ, because when I DJ about the herbal, and I DJ about it. And as I say, from transition from the artist to the herbal, as I say, what made me transition from the artist to the herbal is because when me start get feel away sick and start feel funny in my body, I may have experience about changing my body in a way. I have to go to herbal one doctor, hospital or something. But when I go there, so I want to stick to the great grandmother and grandfather, grow up the herbs and feed up on the herbs, and you know. So from this, you know, from the music to the herbal man, and it was a good change because herbal man now is our next name change, because Dickie Rankin, Snagga Puss, herbal man. So herbal man is a different name, and herbal man have to deal with the herbal. So from that part, you know, in the music, the transition, you know, to bring the dancehall and the herbal together. So I say, yes, let me get a chance, can take care of myself and take care of enough entertainer, enough people, and it open the music, open the door for the herbal man, because the music take me for enough interviews, enough round the world, and so I can tell people about the herbal and a lot of things about herbal and how to take care of themselves, because I'm learning every day. Okay. So the music teach me, and it take me to another level. Right. So the transition was beautiful. As I say, some people say, yeah, Tabo, you're herbal man, and you're herbal this, and rare, and sometimes they come with question. So, what cause diabetes? What cause cancer? What cause this, and what cause that? So yeah, me have to give them an answer.
So they challenge you then, because they wanted to see if you had knowledge on what you were saying.
What you were saying. Are you just a, be a herbal man, I don't know nothing.
Right.
So I just tell him, say, well, and then I say, come back to DJ, man, because the herbal now agree with you, car. How long will the herbal now give you money like with the music you give? I say, herbal give me more money than the music. The herbal give me more money than the music. I can do a show or a song and get a million now. And I can book a man who's sick of cancer and give him up to die. And he is a billionaire. And him say, I will pay you anything if you can make me live past or so. And I make him live past or so. So right there, so I become a billionaire too. I remember an interview with a man, and this man have cancer, and the doctor give him up to die. And go to a herbalist and say, it's $10,000 I'm going to make a medicine for me special. And the man, I make the medicine, but I never finish it. And the man go and say, $50,000 more US there. More you make the medicine for me. And he make the medicine. And when the medicine and the man live past the 3 months where them say I was dead. And that man is alive today. And you know him do? He go to the man and say, what you want? He asks the man, what you want? And say, I want a lab. And I want a nice house. And buy my nice house, the lab, and buy my Chris BMW. So all of the herbalists them I used to get. Dr. Sebi, if you know this great herbalist, Dr. Sebi, who is one of my teachers. Mm-hmm. Because I learned from everyone. Dr. Sebi, Dr. Africa, Dr. Malachi. And the one who made me know the most is Dr. Malachi. Because Malachi let me know about the particles, the atoms and the atoms, and everything about the biocellular body and the spiritual world.
Okay.
So that's why I show respect to Dr. Malachi Ziyak. Okay. You understand me? Okay. He's alive and he's well.
Okay, so as a herbalist now, give us some herbal remedies, we call it.
Right.
For common disorders that most persons will have, like stress. You said stress was one of the main thing persons were coming to you.
Stress is one of,
You could give us for stress, you could give us for diabetes, you could give us for low blood count, infertility. See. So, all right. So those are four.
Four. Mm-hmm. We start with stress. Stress is when the body, you're not asleep. You not get for rest. You're confused. You don't solve your problem. So it will stress you. And when it's stress, you know, the body release certain chemical, certain acid, where it starts to go in a state of disorder. And if you want to get rid of that stress, you have to solve the problem. Plus you get mineral that help you to detox. Like, for instance, you have a herb called soursop leaf, breadfruit leaf, mango leaf, shemo lady. Yeah, and them call it shemo lady, which is them call it electrical plant. Why them call it shemo lady? Because when you touch it, it just lock
close
up. Close up. So we call it the electrical plant. Okay? And those plants are with a thing called the sea mineral now, which is algae. Algae means anything that grows in water, which is oxygen food. So the watercress, the water grass, the spirulina, the Irish marsh, the kelp, name the seaweed them. They are algae. So those can help you with stress because those minerals give you omega 3, which is a brain food, and which is a protein food again. Omega 3, B12, iodine, and all these things. So that helps you with stress because it helps strengthen back the body. And it helps you to overcome a problem if you have a problem and not solving, because what you need to solve a problem, you have to have energy. If you don't have no energy, you have been fatigued and lethargic and down.
Okay.
Diabetes now, when the pancreas start breakdown, it now produce the insulin. Then you have a thing named the vagus nerves. It want to clean because most people doesn't detox them body. And most people don't clean themselves. Them clean them house, them care, them wash them clothes. How much people remember, I said, the body have to clean. The body have the organs, them. It have the blood for clean. It have the nerves, cells, them for clean. And it have it inner being and the inner for clean. So you don't clean your body, then the diabetes gonna take you over now. The diabetes, no blood sugar get high, no insulin. Then you start to have nerves problem, cramping and numbing and tingling. All of these things caused by diabetes, blood clot, strokes, heart attack. All these things caused by diabetes.
Okay. As we close off, any advice that you would like to leave with our viewers?
Well, all the advice I'm giving the viewers, as me say, have a mind of your own. Don't make nobody think for you. Think for yourself, because everything in this universe now is self-reliant, self-confident. The greatest power that you have, it's inside of you. Inner being, inner strength, inner man. And we are a child of the universe. When I mean child of the universe, we are a product. We are the heat, the water, the air, the atoms, the particles, the molecules. We are everything. You hear them say, we are the world, we are the people. Okay? And remember again now, the oneness, unity, strength. So you must show love and respect for each other. don't disrespect no man, because if you disrespect any man, you disrespect yourself. And you disrespect God. And you know how it goes when you disrespect the Creator. You have no chance. So unity is strength. Come together, show respect for each other, love each other, and love yourself. It's like my new dance. You come now, it named Selfie. Take out your phone and video yourself. Walk around and video yourself. Pose, take a picture with yourself. It's all about you and yourself. You look good. You look well. Pamela Jaycee and Michelle. Selfie. Selfie. We are going to do the dance. Name Selfie. So, in name Selfie, love yourself. And for you to love anybody else, you have to love yourself first. So, my advice to all of you, love God. Love yourself. Love each other. Unity. Unity. Just unite. We are all one.
Thank you very much. And where can we find you?
884-8176. That's the Herbal Man digit. You can call me or give me a visit. I'm the human mechanic. I'm responsible for this planet. Okay? So 884-8176. That's my number. That number can save your life. That number can help you on many occasions. All you need advice, you can call me. And I can visit you no matter where you are. I'll be there.
Thank you very much, Snagga Puss. It was my pleasure in interviewing you today. This is certainly one of the reasons why I enjoy doing Real Talk Jamaica. I get to meet exceptional people. Thank you for joining us as we explore the fascinating journey of Snagga Puss, an artist who reminds us that music is as much about joy and laughter as it is about rhythm and beats. Remember to like, share, and subscribe. Follow us on all platforms at Real Talk Jamaica. Also, check out Instinct Media Production page. The information is below. I am Quanna Harris, signing off. Continue to keep it real. Hey there, like what you see? Want to keep watching? Click here for more videos.